Friends and families, welcome back to the My Miller Show. This is your host, My Miller. If you haven't subscribed to BIMO TV yet, please subscribe to BIMO TV so next time when I bring entrepreneurs and business owners onto my show, you can see my videos. So today is a very special day. I have two very special guests here today, and we are going to talk a little bit about the market rate, market industry, because it's such a hot topic today. Everybody wants to know what the market will be like in the next year, next couple months to a year, and if you're planning on buying, what can you do to get yourself ready. So I have two very special guests here today. So I have Jake here, and I also have Brady here today. Hey. Welcome to my show.
Thanks so much for having us.
Yeah.
Truly appreciate it.
Thanks for coming on. So first of all, tell me a little bit more about you both, who you are, what do you do, and
My name is Brady Hahn. I'm a real estate agent just like yourself. I work with eXp Realty and the Tyler Miller team. Been doing it for about 10 months now and just absolutely love it.
It's killing it too. I saw it.
Yes, it's so much fun to see success so early on, and it just keeps me pushing every day.
So. Wow. I mean, I'm just like watching. I'm like, man, like he's so young. I mean, how old are you?
I'm 21.
Wow.
21 in like 5 months.
Legal to drink.
The best.
I am finally able to, when I first started, my first client was like, after we close, we got to go get a couple beers. And I'm like, I can't.
Yeah.
Rain check.
Rain check.
Can't celebrate yet. Yeah. We'll do it like in a couple months.
Yeah. And then we actually did. And then we're sitting there having a beer and they got a phone call from their friend that wanted to buy a house. So it's just like everything happened for a reason. And it was so much fun.
Wow. That's amazing. What about you, Jake?
My name is Jake Latrell. I work at Edge Home Finance as the media and marketing manager. I started out as a mortgage broker. And then the owner of Edge was like, wait a second, I like your videos and the content you're putting out. We need someone like that. So, I kind of took on that role and I love it.
Yeah.
It's so fun. And
you do such a great job too editing, cause you guys have the Pod Gods. So if you guys haven't seen it, Pod Gods on YouTube, so subscribe and watch some of their videos. They do a really good job. And Jake does a good job editing too.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Yeah. How long does it take for you to edit a video?
It depends how many angles there are. The one that we just recently did took a few hours just because there was a little audio issue. But usually like an hour, and then Brady does the clips, and you know, we're posting them on Instagram and TikTok and Spotify. So we've kind of streamlined it, though.
Yeah.
It's a lot of fun.
Yeah.
It is.
Yeah. How was the transition? How are you transitioning from mortgage broker to doing media? I mean, total different outlets, right?
Yeah. So, I started out as a mortgage broker, and, you know, I dug deep and, you know, I got licensed as a loan officer, and that was my main goal, and I'm learning and soaking up. It's like when you first start out, it's like drinking water through a fire hose. There's so much to learn. Mm-hmm. And you meet so many different people, and it's really overwhelming. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, one, I started doing video content just to market myself and get my name out there on social media and stay on top of mind. And I realized, like, man, I love this. I used to do YouTube years ago, and luckily my boss was like, do that. Keep doing that. And then, you know, if people, you know, like Brady and I closed a deal.
Yeah.
But a lot of times, you know, I'll do the introduction and I'll hand it off to someone on my team who I know is highly capable. Mm-hmm. And it's been awesome.
So you're still engaged, you're still doing it, but you're just, you know, you have a team. So your team does, they close it for you.
Yep. Yeah.
Yeah. Wow. That's awesome.
It's great.
Yeah. So for you, Brady, you're so young, like we talked about, you're not legal to drink yet, or just about, right?
Yeah.
What made you think that real estate was for you, and how did you first get into it, and why real estate?
Right, that's the question. So I used to work sales. I used to work at a Polo Ralph Lauren, just kind of like a sales guy there. And that was such a different atmosphere is like, buy these pairs of pants and I'll never see you again, where this is right. Let's be best friends for like ever, like I want to get to know you, your family, and be friends with you. So I kind of have the sales background a little bit. I helped my parents kind of find their house, like Zillow, and kind of work with the agent because I knew them. And seeing how happy they were, I was like, if I could do that every day, that would be pretty cool.
Yeah.
So I went to college, basically a full ride to go play golf. Did it for a year and decided.
So you're a golfer too?
Big time.
Amazing. Oh,
you
golfer.
And my husband will be best friends.
Amazing golf.
Yeah, I used to play like all over the country in different golf tournaments. Yeah. So I went to college for that. Dropped out, met my boss now, Tyler, and had a great experience with him. Called my coach, and my coach was like, hey, like, that's the worst decision you could ever make. Like, what are you thinking? And I'm like, that's not the support I'm looking for. So I actually...
Where's the support?
Right? I just didn't have it there. And it was one of the reasons I decided not to go back to college, and then just the real estate fell into my lap, and I'm like, I think I could be really good at this, and I'm not going to give it, like, I'm not going to go into it part-time if I'm doing this.
Yeah.
I'm going full at it. I'm going to work 90 hours a week. Like, let me put in everything I got to see if I'll be successful. Mm-hmm. And I did that in November, December, January, when the market was trash.
Right.
And then February, March, April, like, I got 4 offers accepted in 10 days.
Wow,
and
that's crazy.
Like, this is what I've been looking for. And now I've been just striving that every single day, meeting new people, meeting new clients, and helping them reach their goals. And then the best part about it is at closing, getting to hand like a key to a first-time home buyer and seeing their face. Oh,
very fulfilling.
It's so nice. Yeah. And I just that's the best part about it. I have 2 closings next week, both with first-time home buyers. And I'm so happy for that moment.
That's amazing.
Yes.
And it seems like you're doing it really well too. I mean, you educate your clients through the process, and you know, your relationship with them isn't just to close a house, but you want to maintain that relationship after closing, right? Yeah.
Yes. Well, one of the things that I've learned at my brokerage and just meeting with different people I'm really close with, like the DeRoche group, and one thing they taught me was that after closing, that's not when the relationship ends. Mm-hmm. Like, take them to dinner. Dinner, they've never been, like, a Manny's Steakhouse, a Baltimore. Mm-hmm. I took one client to Pittsburgh Blue, and we're sitting there, and they're, like, almost in tears. Like, we haven't had a meal like this in, like, 3 years. And, like, that just, I was like, that's what this is about.
Yeah.
I'll offer housewarming parties, and people love
when
I can provide food for their family and friends, and now I get to get in front of a bunch of people.
Yeah, I love steak, too, by the way.
I'll add, too. Sorry. Brady is one of the most likable guys. Genuinely, seriously though, I'm not just saying this because the camera's on. I've told him this before. Mm-hmm. He's one of the most likable guys, and he's so genuine.
Yeah.
Yes. Just, he stays up so late trying to help his clients. He works so hard. I like forget that he's only 21. It's
right.
Crazy. I'm trying to imagine me when I was 21.
Most 21s are like out there partying, having fun, you know, going to college, you know.
He's so driven, and it's inspiring.
That's amazing.
Yeah. For sure.
Yeah. I mean, I can see the drive and the passion that you have, and not a lot of people, you know, I mean, that's your age would have that, you know, but I mean, I see that you got something good going. It's, you know, it's going to take off really well. So I'm really proud of you.
I appreciate that. Yeah. And I can only thank my parents to get me and teach me to be the person I am.
Yeah.
See how they grew up. It's been so, so nice to have really good parents.
Yeah. So a little bit about your parents, like,
They've actually met in kindergarten.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they have known each other forever.
Wow.
My dad and my uncle were best friends. They lived in Durango, Colorado for like 6 months together. They came back, and my dad and my mom started dating. And like,
how old were they?
They didn't start dating until like 22.
Oh, okay.
I was gonna say kindergarten. Yeah. Ooh, that's
like 22.
Times were different back then.
And my dad brought my uncle, my mom's brother, when he went to go buy the ring for my mom. And my uncle's like, are you sure you want to do this? Like, maybe we should go get a drink and see if it's the right choice.
Right.
So, like, my family, we're all so connected. And I can't thank my parents enough. And I moved out of my parents' house in June.
Mm-hmm.
And it was really hard on my mom.
Oh,
and
my
it
bad.
Still is. But I make sure to call her at least once a day to check in on her and just be like, hey, mom, I'm here for you. Unfortunately, last week, my mom's mom passed away.
Oh, sorry to hear.
And that was really tough on just kind of my whole family, and especially my mom. And I talked to Jake about it a lot because, I mean, we're like two peas in a pod.
Yeah.
And he's like, the number one thing you're going to do is be there for your mom.
Yeah.
And that's all I've really tried to do, because I know she'd be there for me if I lost someone that close. So.
That's good. I mean, you're so young, family-oriented, career-oriented. I mean, what else, right? Family man, right? So yes, all good traits. And
Yeah. No girlfriend.
Well, he's, you know, we can turn this into a dating show.
Bring her out. Contestant number one. No.
Yeah. So you are the oldest, or?
I'm the youngest. Okay, so I have two older brothers. One's actually getting married in October. I'm at CHS Field here in St. Paul, which is going to be really cool to finally have a sister in my family. Sister-in-law, and she is amazing. So happy for my brother. And I have an older brother. He has Asperger's.
Oh, okay.
Lives at home with my parents. Mm-hmm. So we've struggled to connect because I'm so outgoing and he's kind of more just sheltered stay-at-home guy. But absolutely love that guy. Love my whole family.
That's amazing. I mean, being the baby, it's probably hard for her because her baby is moving out, right? And she's not ready for that yet.
She's not. And like, when I was moving out, she's like, this is so different than college. College, I knew you were going to come back, but now it's like, you're gone. Mm-hmm. Like, you're not going to live here anymore.
Right.
Like, yeah.
But at least you're not too far from home.
I'm like 30 minutes.
Yeah.
But that's like super far. She lives in the middle of the woods, like 10 acres. And I live in this Champlin now right by Jake. And
I kept telling him too. I was like, it's going to be tough. You know, there's going to be times you're going to miss your parents. And he's just been thriving.
Yeah.
Like,
he's on a podcast and my boss Tyler was on and he's like, it's not going to be as great as you think. And I called him like after 2 days. I'm like, dude, this is the best thing.
Mom, if you're listening.
I'm sorry.
So homesick. Poor guy.
He's not homesick at all. If he said he is, he's not.
Man.
It's just been such a different experience. And I think it's so weird living by yourself at 21 in a one-bedroom apartment. There's days where I'm like, this is so nice after interacting with people all day to just come home and like just not have to do anything.
Right. Yeah.
And then there's times where it's like, dang, I'm kind of lonely.
Yeah.
Like, I need that compassion or someone to be there. So I'm like,
maybe mom's cooking is the best too.
Like, yeah.
Oh, a cat.
My mom to cook.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Oh. So I've really been missing that. But I used to cook in college for like all the golf teams. So I would cook them shrimp scampi. Like, I'd cook them all kinds of stuff. Nothing they were getting at the calf, so.
That's better than what I would probably offer. Like, maybe like, hey, let's order pizza.
That was Saturday night.
Great, though.
Saturday night, 2 a.m. That's when we're getting pizza.
Yeah.
After the bars.
Yeah. What about you, Jake? What did you do before you came into the industry?
I was an activity director at a nursing home for 8 years. A little over 8 years. I loved it. I loved, you know, being of service for the elderly, and it was kind of, I didn't realize how much I loved it until I left.
Aww.
And then I was like, I don't know, it's just, it's very fulfilling. Mm-hmm. This job is as well, obviously, but you know, this job pays a little more. But I realized, like, after my fiance and I had our son, I needed to do something bigger. Mm-hmm. And I feel like I kind of reached the cap at the nursing home. Mm-hmm. And even though I loved it and, you know, it was great and I felt so, like, needed and wanted and I felt like I had a purpose, I needed to do something bigger and, you know, something for me and my family.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
Yeah. So you went from working with elderly to young folks, right? How's the transition? Like, just...
It's...
Communication is probably different.
Yeah, I don't have to yell in their hearing aid. I need, you know, and then also.
Or you don't have to repeat it 10 times.
Yes, yeah. And you know, going from a nursing home where the majority is a lot of like female like nurses and aides and stuff like that, going from that environment to an office full of guys, there's a little bit of difference there.
Yeah.
But I love it though. It's something I've been missing for a while, that camaraderie with the guys and girls in the office, obviously. But
and I'm so glad you did, otherwise we would have never met, right? I mean,
I
felt like we met through, what is it, Facebook?
Yeah.
And then
I think you post something, or maybe I asked you a question about your show or something.
Something. Yeah.
And anyways.
Yeah, but I mean, it's so amazing how things can bring us a different path and we meet new people, and those new people make such a big impact in our life and it changes everything.
I remember I think we kind of started at this around the same time, and I remember both of us meeting at Caribou. It's like every Friday or every other Friday.
Yeah.
And in the very beginning, and we're both, I don't want to say naive, but kind of just, we're still like so excited and learning and talking about business, and then going from, you know, that was what, 8 months ago? Maybe?
It was like October.
Of last year? Oh, wow. Going from that to now where we both, you know, talk to each other daily, multiple times a day.
He's like pinned on like my text messages. He's he's favorite in my car. I'm just hitting him on my car. Like, he's really just grown to be one of my best friends.
That's awesome. It's really cool.
Have each other on speed dial all the time.
Yeah. 100%.
And we're always bouncing ideas off each other. That was the best thing about it. Because when we first started talking, I think I might have brought up podcasts first.
Yeah.
And you're like, that's such a cool, unique idea. Like, I need to look into that. And now we have a podcast together that's just thriving. And
it's fun. And I will say, you know, I'm like the video editor guy.
Mm-hmm.
He makes the best clips. I just want to throw that out there. He sent me a couple clips because, you know, I do like the whole video, and then he'll do clips and a lot of the social posts. But I'm like, man, this guy makes some good clips. But yeah.
Yeah, that's awesome. I mean, I don't know. I love doing it, but man, the editing.
Yeah.
That's a lot of work. Like, does it take you a long time? And
yeah, it depends. So like, I'll do a lot of, or not a lot, but sometimes I'll do like passion project videos for like my own stuff. And that's way more fun to edit.
Yeah.
Cause you know, you're emotionally involved in it. You want it to look cool. And then there's, you know, stuff that you have to do for work, and it's still fun. I love editing and seeing it all come together. But, yeah, you have to have like a love for it.
Yeah,
otherwise you're just going to be miserable staring. Like you watch, say you make a video, you have to watch it like 500 times before and hear the same. If there's a song in it, you have to hear the song 500 times.
Right.
And by the end, you're just like, ah, just upload, get out of here.
Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah. Cause I mean, it's such a hard piece too. But, so Brady, so you're killing it this year, right? What are some things that you are doing that you think that is helpful in your business?
I think some of the stuff I've been doing lately is going to, I just do a lot of open houses. Mm. That's my bread and butter. I was never a big cold calling guy. I did that for a while. I just wasn't that good on the phone. I'm such a face-to-face person where I can read people's emotions, different things like that. And I've learned to just be genuine, like Jake mentioned, with people, and we just connect so much better. Been at open houses, I'm like, yeah, I may be 21, but I bet your agent isn't gonna go door knock any neighborhood you want and see if someone wants to sell, because that's what I'll do for you.
Mm-hmm.
Like, just outworking everybody, I think that's what's really been beneficial for me. And then just growing my business and getting like trust in my sphere of influence. My family and friends are now like texting me and being like, hey, how much is my house worth? Because they can trust me, they see the success. They know, they trust me, they like me, and they know me. As I mentioned earlier, that's the number one thing you need in the industry. So that's something I've really been focusing on, because you got to be known, you got to be liked, and you got to be trusted to be successful.
Yeah. So, I mean, so what are your thoughts when people say that you're too young? I mean, if they have a lack of trust because of your age, like, what do you do to win their trust, right?
I always say, so I am on an amazing team at an amazing brokerage. Yeah, you may be working with a 21-year-old, but you're also working with my whole team. Tyler's been in the business for 15 years. If you have a question and you ask me and I don't know it, I'm going to be like, hey, I don't know that answer right now. Give me 5 minutes. Let me make a call and I'll get it. If Tyler doesn't know that answer, I can call Daniel DeRoche, Julie DeRoche, Parker Pepperton, the top agents in the state of Minnesota. And if they don't know, I have connections out in California, all over the world I can call because of my brokerage. We're all working together because they understand that this is a team game. We want to help people get into houses, so let's work together to do that. So yeah, I may be 21 and you're working with me, but you're also working with 10,000 other agents across the world.
Wow. Because
that's how my brokerage works.
Yeah, awesome. And Tyler's such an amazing guy too.
Yeah. He knows so much.
He's got a really good system.
He does. Mm-hmm. So that's what's, it's been super beneficial.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm young. I use all the people behind me for that, but I also use that I'm young.
Mm-hmm.
That 45-year-old agent that you want to work with has a wife, has kids.
Mm-hmm.
You want to go see a house at 7 p.m.? they probably can.
Yeah.
I can. I'm single. I can do whatever you want. I'm there for you.
Quit bragging.
Yeah. Plus you're
must be
more...
nice.
Yeah.
I'm more driven probably too. Like I want to find that perfect house for you because I have the time and I have the passion to do it right now. Mm-hmm. I've not been in the industry for 20 years. I'm burned out. I want to be done with this.
Yeah. Most hungry for success, most hungry for knowledge, you know, and then you're probably gonna, like you said, just the free time that you have, you can show them homes at 8 p.m. at night or 7 p.m. or on the weekends.
Whenever.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
He's so consistent too. You know, you can always count on him posting a Monday market update.
Yes.
I see those videos every
so
day.
So good.
Every week.
Yeah.
I'm coming up on 1 year.
Yeah. Really?
Yep. Labor Day.
Just crushing. Yeah.
Consistency is so important in our business too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
Just being known.
Staying on top of mind.
The real person. That's what I love about the podcasts and stuff like this, is because you get to show your true self. When people look up my name and they're like, I saw you had a podcast. You're such a cool, genuine guy. Like, I want to work with you because you're not fake. You're not phony. Mm. I think that's so big.
100%.
Yeah, that makes sense, yeah. Most importantly, like, they don't have commission breath. Right, in our business.
Ooh.
If you have commission breath, oh man, it's like...
I haven't heard that one before. That's good. That's really good.
A lot of agents do, too.
Mm-hmm.
Smell it, too, for sure.
Yeah, yeah, because I feel like when I first got into the industry, that's one thing I learned is don't have commission breath. And people love you because of the compassion and that you genuinely want to help them instead of coming in for the transaction. So.
Well, you can tell, too, like when we had you on the Realtor of the Week, just you're emotionally involved and want to help regardless of money.
Yes.
You could just tell.
Yeah.
And yeah.
Yeah. I think you can differentiate the good realtors. I mean, there's, you know, all kinds of realtors, and I think that not everybody's the same, or even like in your business too, like, you know, mortgage brokers, not everybody's the same. Everybody offers something differently, and it's, you know, that's why it's so good to shop around.
Right? Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yeah. That's what I like about Edge and, you know, the broker world is you can lower your comp to help your clients.
Yeah.
I've seen that happen so many times.
Yeah, and you do a lot of that too, is, you know, when your clients can't bring enough money to closing, what do you do,
right?
Yeah, we
have so much freedom on the broker side. It's it's pretty amazing. Yeah.
So with your new marketing that you're doing, are you open to do it to the public or other realtors?
Yeah. So I, you know, my regular, you know, I'm able to leave work when I don't have other, you know, tasks at work going on. Otherwise, I'm available weekends after work. You know, I just did a commercial for a roofing company yesterday. So I kind of dabble everywhere.
Okay.
I love it. So if anybody's out there that wants to shoot anything, let me know. I do editing and video. So
yeah, I would love to. Let's connect after this.
Yeah.
I think that it's such an important piece having someone like you, and, you know, not just like real estate, but, you know, sales in today's market. It's so important, you know, because marketing, our Gen Z, you know, our kids generate Gen Z. they're like so big on like other influencer pages like Instagram, Snapchat. Like, I'm not even on Snapchat.
Yeah.
I'm barely on Instagram. You probably know that.
Yeah.
TikTok is one of them that's really big. And I think that, you know, marketing, having you around someone like you is a huge piece.
Yeah. It's, you know, there's old advertisement where, you know, billboards and newspaper ads and stuff like that. But being able to post on social media and pay, you know, a fraction of the price to repost, you know, if you have 3 videos, you can post one for a month, another one for the next month, with, like I said, a fraction of the price compared to commercials and TV.
Definitely.
It's pretty cool.
So most importantly, I want to talk about our market today, right?
Yes.
So where do you guys think that our market is going to take us with our current interest rate in next year's election year?
Yes.
What do you guys think about our market in the next couple of months?
I think rates will go down prior to election. Yeah. It seems to be a reoccurring thing.
Yeah, I was just going to say election year. It's very common for rates to go down.
Yeah.
Economy to get better a little bit. Mm-hmm. At least we hope it does, right?
Yeah.
But I think as rates fall, and a lot of people are waiting for rates to drop before they go buy, I think it's going to be a hit in the face when rates drop and they realize, wow, there's 20 offers on this house.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I should have bought
last year,
right now.
Yep.
The time we're in now.
Mm-hmm.
And then refinance once rates drop.
Mm-hmm.
So I think big thing I'm trying to do on my social media platforms is tell people, like, hey, let's buy now.
Mm-hmm.
Then we can refinance, right? Everyone says,
Lock down your price. Yep.
Marry the house, date the rate, because we can just refinance.
Yep, exactly.
In this market, I think that's going to be very huge, and I don't think a lot of people get that. Mm-hmm. Where everyone's saying, "There's the market's going to crash, mm-hmm. prices are going to go through the roof, I'll just buy a foreclosure." Like, I just saw something
it's
today.
Not the
there's
same.
Like, there's yeah. no foreclosures like anywhere.
Yeah.
I had one guy tell me, he's like, "Well, I saw foreclosures are up 200% in the last 2 years." I'm like, well, from zero to two, yeah, that's 200%. There's just not that many out there.
Right.
I realized, too, you know the owner of MBS Highway? I forgot his name.
I don't.
He's, like, a big mortgage guy. And
is it Barry Habib?
Yes. Barry Habib stated, it was, like, 6 to 8 months ago, that, oh, rates are going to go down again by this time. And I realized there's no magic ball. You just never know. Even the most professional people in the industry who are experts, they don't know. They can only go off patterns and data that they've seen in the past. It's just hard to pinpoint.
That makes sense. But we all know that election year rates do come down a
yes.
little bit, right?
Yes.
So, you know, but however, like what Brady said, it's the best time to buy is now, because like next year you're going to be competing against 20 other people, and you're going to be buying $50,000 over the list price.
Yep.
So at that time, you know, if you factor in $50,000 and next amortization for 30 years, you know, they're paying way more than what you want to.
Yeah. No, at least you have a little bit of negotiating power.
Yeah.
Compared to what it will be if
you... Even now, you buy a house now, and yeah, prices are going to go up because there's so many buyers. So
yep.
you buy now, you just made more money because of prices go
right.
up, they appreciate. That's just how the market works. Everyone says real estate's a great investment. And these next 5 years, I think it's going to really show.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. Yeah. So one question I really want to ask you guys, be that you're both really successful. What is a, you know, a really good book that you guys really recommend, or something that you guys read that really helped you grow your business?
When I first got in the business, I started reading
How to Win Friends
and Influence People. Mm-hmm. And it really just made me understand you really just have to be a genuine person, and mm-hmm. and life is crazy.
Right.
It will all come to you. And it's something that really changed my mindset on how to talk to people and how to interact. It's not only helped me in my sales life, but my personal life with my family, and, you know, maybe dates I'd go on, and to truly understand who a person is. I think that book really, I don't want to say changed my life, but changed my life.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Made me the person I am today.
Wow.
And just everything I went through dropping out of college, like
mm-hmm.
that's a lot of stress.
Yeah.
So it was a really good time to really, you know, I journaled a lot, I meditated a lot, and I read a lot.
Wow.
And How to Win Friends and Influence People really, really helped me a lot.
I'm going to have to read that book, because you're only 21.
Read it?
Not yet.
Oh, it's like,
It's right up there with like Rich Dad Poor Dad.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, Rich Dad. That's a good book too. Rich Dad Poor Dad. I think almost everybody's read that book.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Or there's another book, Millionaire.
Oh, the Million Dollar.
It's all about real estate and how to create a team and different ways. You know, maybe you get a VA, or you know, you start giving people other jobs that you don't want to do,
mm-hmm.
TCs, whatever it might be. So that was kind of cool to kind of have like a back end of real estate before I really understood. Because
mm-hmm.
I got my license at the time. I was like, I'm doing a marketing degree. If I get into real estate or have my real estate license, maybe that'll come in handy one day.
Mm-hmm.
And then life's crazy. You never know where you're going to be.
Right.
I think 2 years ago today, I was in my dorm room for the first time. And now I'm here.
Look
so
at you selling houses. So what about you?
I read a book a while ago called The Secret. It's basically about the law of attraction and manifesting good things in your life. Honestly, a lot of the stuff I listen to kind of motivate me and learn is podcasts. There's a ton of podcasts out there that I'll just throw on and listen to in the car. And it kind of, even if I'm not picking anything up that I can use, I'm subconsciously taking it in and applying it during my daily life.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So
I feel like we learn so much from people. I mean, I've learned so much from just talking with you guys today, you know, in like 10 minutes time frame. It's just, you know, so much to learn from other people. So is there anything that you guys want to address to our audience? And then also, if they want to reach out to you, how do they reach out to you guys?
Check out our podcast,
yes.
The Pod Gods. On YouTube, Spotify, you can reach out to me on Facebook, Jake LaTorrell. Instagram, Jake_the_broker. I think that's all I got.
Yeah, definitely check out the podcast. It's a lot of fun. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, LinkedIn, Brady Holland. I want to say Brady_Holland_realtor on TikTok and Instagram. Check out the Monday market updates. It's fun. As well, just reach out for any real estate needs. If you guys have questions or want to learn more or just even get into the business, I have a webinar coming up where I'm teaching people what classes to take, how to get into the industry, and where to start. Because I've had a lot of family and friends ask me, like, how did you even do this? Mm-hmm. So reach out. I'd love to get you guys on the webinar. It's free.
So. Wow, that's amazing. Yeah. Well, thank you so much, you guys, for coming to my show. Yeah. I really enjoyed it. I feel like we could talk forever.
Yeah.
There's so many things to talk about. You know, we can always come back and, you know, next year maybe.
Yeah.
And just see how things are. And
when we're famous.
Yeah.
I will say the studio, if you guys saw the other side of this, is so awesome.
It's
professional.
Amazing.
It's
from the podcast that we do.
Like, with two little DSLR cameras.
You guys have such a cool setup too.
Thank you.
It's fun.
Yeah.
Yeah. And thank you so much for coming in today. I really appreciate it. And, you know, thank you everybody for tuning in to the My Miller Show. If you haven't subscribed to Baymo TV, please subscribe to Baymo TV. Please share this video. If you have any friends that are in the real estate needs, feel free to reach out to Jake and Brady. They are both top producers and they would be great to work with if you guys are looking to buy or sell in the future. Feel free to reach out to them. Otherwise, this is your host, My Miller. Thanks for tuning in. I will see you guys next time.